Are you a social purpose organization working hard to meet the needs of your stakeholders in a rapidly changing landscape during a global pandemic? Are you a monitoring and evaluation specialist? A lot has changed in the last few months. From a local health crisis, we've now shifted into a global health and economic meltdown. Inequality has become much more pronounced, and while some are able to continue to make ends meet from home with a roof over their head, a remote job, reliable Wi-Fi, and enough food or access to food delivery services, many others do not have that choice and are at a much greater health and economic risk. Hey everyone, my name is Chris Gaines, lead trainer at SOPACT. I hope that everyone is staying safe, whether you're staying home or on the front lines providing invaluable support to the public. In this video, we'll examine why funders will need to keep investing in reliable social outcome data post-COVID-19. Today, social purpose organizations have a greater challenge to meet. Things have dramatically shifted in key human development sectors like economic growth, nutrition, health, and education. To take an example from education, we are inadvertently running the largest homeschooling program ever developed for over 1 billion kids, completely blindfolded. There is no cohesive strategy, allocated resources, designed success metrics, or even a plan for evaluating effectiveness. To understand why funding needs to keep flowing to these kinds of programs, let's analyze the 5 main monitoring and evaluation challenges organizations will face post-COVID-19. Stakeholders are more vulnerable and there's a greater chunk of the population in need. Sudden loss of jobs, lockdowns, homeschooling kids, loss in businesses, and the health crisis have magnified the community's needs. The World Bank estimates that the pandemic could push about 49 million people into extreme poverty in 2020 alone. In other words, we need to act fast and we need to act efficiently. Funding may suffer. Nonprofits and micro-entrepreneurs tend to depend on for-profit companies as well as individual donors who are currently in economic distress. The government and large philanthropic organizations will have to step up. There is an emerging need for new ways to collect impactful data. Due to lockdowns and the novel contagion risk, data collection needs to become a primarily remote function. Unfortunately, this introduces additional challenges when dealing with weak local infrastructure, technological literacy, and access to knowledge and information. Digital data also inherently adds biases. For example, across the globe, women are less likely to have a cell phone than men, and thus might not be able to have their voices heard. Shifting monitoring and evaluation priorities and strategy. Funders may be tempted to deprioritize monitoring, evaluation, and learning, or MEL, or attempt to bend their original MEL plan and indicators to fit with their adjusted activities during this time. In this moment of rapid adaptation, rapid and outcome-oriented learning is more important than ever. This means that trying to fit their original strategy to a modified or pivoted program will not necessarily work. For example, an organization working on Sustainable Development Goal 4, bringing quality education to kids in India by training teachers, has now shifted to distributing self-learning kits. Homeschooling children due to COVID-19 must have a different strategy, metrics, and feedback loops, even when the stakeholders and overall goal remain the same. Their evaluation strategy will also have to adapt to reflect this change. The stakes for effectively learning from data just got a lot higher. Grantees will have to build new programs and apply innovative ideas which have never been tested before. It is important to realize that choices being made right now will shape our society for years, if not decades, to come. So now, more than ever, we need short feedback loops to learn everything we can about the effectiveness of our programs and decisions, apply immediate improvements, and measure again until we reach our desired outcomes. So the question becomes, how can we tackle these new challenges? We need investment to flow, not only into programs themselves, but also into the adoption of new technologies that better allow us to collect data and enable rapid and continuous learning. Program evaluators need to be prepared to adopt the tools and techniques of a new age. You need a technology platform that can help you design and document program strategy, align with global standards, collect continuous online and offline data, and learn from intermediate changes rapidly. That is where Impact Cloud comes into the picture. It's a unique, configurable platform that can be up and ready in hours to start collecting your stakeholder data. It's a cloud-based platform that not only meets today's needs, but is built to be flexible and scalable to tackle all of the monitoring, evaluation, and learning challenges organizations will be facing post-COVID-19. In summary, at this moment of crisis, funders must allow and encourage grantees to try their innovative ideas, validate their hypotheses, and enable them to learn fast to make impactful adjustments to their programs. In a matter of months, COVID-19 has taught us what we've failed to learn in the past. The price of inaction on social issues is more than we are willing to pay. I, for one, want to know what is working, where, how fast, and why. Wouldn't you? Well, thanks for watching, everyone. Drop a comment down below and let's get the discussion started. And don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel so you never miss an upload. And until then, this has been Chris Gaines. I'll catch you in the next one.